Step 2 Christ, Chapter 3, Repentance. Page 28. The divine mind that is working upon the things of nature is speaking to the hearts of men and creating an inexpressible craving for something they have not. The things of the world cannot satisfy their longing. The Spirit of God is pleading with them to seek for those things that alone can give peace and rest, the grace of Christ, the joy of holiness. Through influences, seen and unseen, our Savior is constantly at work to attract the minds of men from the unsatisfying pleasures of sin to the infinite blessings that may be theirs in Him. To all these souls who are vainly seeking to drink from the broken cisterns of this world, the divine message is addressed, "Let him that is athirst come, and whoever will, let him take the water of life freely." Revelation chapter 22 verse 17. You who in heart long for something better than this world can give, recognize this longing as the voice of God to your soul. Ask Him to give you repentance, to reveal Christ to you in His infinite love, in His perfect purity. In the Savior's life, the principle of God's love, love to God and man, were perfectly exemplified. Benevolence, unselfish love was the life of His soul. It is as we behold Him, as the light from our Savior falls upon us, that we see the sinfulness of our own hearts. We may have flattered ourselves, as did Nicodemus, that our life has been upright, that our moral character is correct, and think that we need not humble the heart before God, like the common sinner, but when the light from Christ shines into our souls, we shall see how impure we are, we shall discern the selfishness of motive, the enmity against God that has defiled every act of life. Then we shall know that our own righteousness is indeed as filthy rags, and that the blood of Christ alone can cleanse us from the defilement of sin and renew our hearts in His own likeness. Step 2 Christ, page 28, July 10th.